In this video, we will show you how to add a custom domain to a WeWeb project. Because WeWeb doesn't support root domains, you have to choose a subdomain like www. Or app. Or academy. So you need to choose a subdomain. For that reason, we will also show you how to redirect your root domain to the subdomain you chose for your WeWeb app. So here I have a WeWeb project that I published on the WeWeb-preview.io domain. That's all well and good, but I would like to have this as my custom domain. I very modestly called this website Joy Scattering Rocks, and I have a domain name that is joyscattering.rocks. So I am going to link this custom domain to my WeWeb project. In order to do this, back in my project, I can go to dashboard here, the dashboard icon, and go to domains. Or if I was on my workspace, I could go ahead and click on the settings of the projects and then go to domain. I don't have a custom domain yet, so I'm going to add one. And here I'm invited to type in my full domain name. So WeWeb does not support root domain names, so I cannot type in just joyscattering.rocks. I need to choose a subdomain. Common examples include app.domain. For our academy, we have academy.weweb.io. In this case, because it's my personal website, I want to have it on www. It will be my main website. So let's connect the domain. When we do this, WeWeb will invite us to create two CNAME records. One with an SSL certificate, so when you purchase your domain name with whatever domain registrar you chose, you do not have to purchase an SSL certificate. WeWeb will provide that for you. And also a record, a CNAME record, to redirect to the domain you chose, the subdomain you chose, in our case, www. So here you see it says no value found, no value found. This is because we need to create those CNAME records in the DNS. And we do this by going to our domain registrar. This is Namecheap. The same logic would apply on other domain registrars. We will go on the Joy Scattering Rocks domain name and click on manage. And here we'll go to advanced DNS. Again, the interface will change depending on your domain registrar, but you will find that information. You need to look for create CNAME record. Here we'll add a new record and we will look for CNAME. We know it needs to be a CNAME record because it says so here. And we will copy this value. We just need to click on it and the value is copied to the clipboard. And in Namecheap, we'll say in Namecheap, it's called host. In WeWeb, it's name. In different domain registrar, it's called differently. Just know the first value is this one. And then the value you copy from WeWeb will be the corresponding value, the target. So in Namecheap, it's called value. It can be called something else in your domain registrar. Then the TTL in WeWeb, we provide it in seconds. So the equivalent would be 30 minutes. Again, some registrars will give it in seconds, some in minutes like Namecheap. But if you say automatic, that's fine as well. So we'll validate this and we'll create a new record, a new CNAME record, for this time, the www subdomain we chose. So the host will be this and the value will be this. And again, we'll choose 30 minutes, but we could say automatic. That's fine. There's nothing else we need to do for now in Namecheap, but it can take a little bit of time for the DNS to propagate, for the new information to be updated on the DNS throughout the world. Once we've created those two CNAME records in our domain registrar, we need to wait. For what? For the information to be updated in the DNS. A helpful way to think of the DNS is as the phone book of the internet. It's what allows browsers, when we type in a URL, to know the IP address of where the content for that website is. How long do we have to wait? It really depends. It depends on your domain registrar, and it depends on a lot of things. So it can take a few minutes, it can take a few days. If you see that your DNS records have not been propagated after a couple of days, we encourage you to reach out to your domain registrar to find out what's going on. Once the DNS, the domain name system, has been updated with your two CNAME records throughout the world, you will see in WeWeb these values highlighted in green with a little message telling you your DNS is set up correctly. And what that means is that if we now go to joyskettering.rocks, we see our website. However, if we typed in only joyskettering.rocks, we would get an error message. We would not be able to access any pages. If we typed in www.joyskettering.rocks, then we would be able to access the page. This is because in our DNS, we created the CNAME record to host the www subdomain, not the root domain. If we were publishing a project on an app or academy or product subdomain, that would probably be fine because we wouldn't want users to be redirected to our app if they typed in just the root domain. So for example, when someone types in weweb.io in a browser, we don't want to redirect them to the academy.weweb.io app. We want to redirect them to the www website. In order to redirect users who type in the root domain to the www subdomain, we will need to create an alias on the DNS. How you do that will depend on your domain registrar. However, a lot of domain registrars do not allow you to do this type of redirections. So for the purposes of this tutorial, we will show you how to do it in Cloudflare. And you can do this on a free plan in Cloudflare, and it will work no matter what domain registrar you're using. Okay, so in Cloudflare, I will add a site and say joyskettering.rocks. I'll select the free plan and click continue. Now notice that Cloudflare knows that I'm with Namecheap, and they ask me to remove these name servers. So instead of pointing my domain to the Namecheap servers, I can point them to Cloudflare servers instead. So I will copy this and go to Namecheap. In Namecheap, I will go back to my domain. And instead of using Namecheap basic DNS as my name servers, I will add my own custom DNS. And here I will paste the ones that Cloudflare provided. So Ezra and Sarah. Now I will click here to save. And Cloudflare warns me that it can take 24 hours to process the name server updates. They tell me I will receive an email when it's done. So let me just try to accelerate the process just a little bit by asking Cloudflare to check for the name servers of choicekettering.rocks. Again, they asked me to wait a few hours for an update, so I will do so. And we're back. Cloudflare sent me an email to let me know that choicekettering.rocks was active, and I can see on my Cloudflare dashboard that it is indeed active. So let's go inside the project and look at our DNS records. What this looks like in your project may vary depending on what you configured previously in your domain registrar. What's important is that you want to make sure that the two CNAME records that were requested by WeWeb are indeed visible in Cloudflare. If not, you will have to add the records yourself. So you can click on Add Record and then choose CNAME and then copy paste the names and target that are provided in WeWeb. You see here, for example, that WeWeb no longer finds the value. It says our DNS is not valid. That is because the record is no longer in Namecheap and we haven't yet created it properly in Cloudflare. If I go back to Cloudflare, let me cancel this because I have these two records here. The issue is that this one here is proxied. So it's important that I edit it and I remove the proxy status and click save. I will need to wait a little bit for this to be updated. So even if I refresh the page in WeWeb, it may still be red. But while we wait for the CNAME record to be updated, there's a third record we will create in Cloudflare. And it's the reason we are using Cloudflare, because it allows us to do this and a lot of domain registrars don't. So you see here, Cloudflare invites us to create an AAAA or CNAME record for your root domain, so that when someone types in joyscattering.rocks, this makes me laugh every time, it will resolve. So the problem with an A record is that it wants an IP address, and the same goes for the 4A record. But we don't have an IP address to redirect to. What we have is a target, and the target is www.choicekettering.rocks. The root we can just say at. So we want an alias. We want choicekettering.rocks to be an alias of www.choicekettering.rocks. And you should have its traffic proxied through Cloudflare if you want this to work. Let me save this. If you hover over this little info icon, you will see Cloudflare has a very specific technical way of handling this. That's why it's important that the proxy status is proxied for this alias DNS record. Okay, now there's one last thing we want to do in Cloudflare is create a rule, a page rule, so that when someone types in the root domain, whatever, you know, comes after the slash, if they connect to the homepage or the blog or the dashboard, whatever the slug that comes afterwards, that's why we're putting a star. We want to permanently forward the URL using a 301 permanent redirect to https www, so our subdomain, choicekettering.rocks. And here we'll add a dollar sign and a one. And this is very specific to how Cloudflare works. It is so that this slug will take into account whatever the user typed in. You can learn more about Cloudflare page rules. They have an article here. But if you save this, so joyscatering.rocks/star, a permanent 301 resolves on the subdomain with the SSL certificate, so the HTTPS protocol. Let's save and employ the page rule and make sure it's enabled. You can disable it, you can experiment with or without it. We want it enabled. Now again, we wait for these new settings to be propagated, to be sent through the entire phone book of the internet, the DNS, and all the countries around the world. Adding a custom domain, setting DNS records takes a long time. It takes patience. I highly encourage you to be patient and not change settings and refresh, because that's the best way to get lost and forget what settings you tried and which ones you didn't. After waiting, let's say between 5 minutes and an hour after creating the alias record in Cloudflare for the root redirection and adding the page rule, we can go ahead and type in the root domain, press enter, and you see the SSL certificate is working properly and the user is correctly redirected to the www subdomain, so our WeWeb app. That's it. That's how you can add a custom domain to a WeWeb project. A few key takeaways. Number one, WeWeb does not support root domains, so you will need to choose a subdomain such as app or academy or www to serve your WeWeb app online. Number two, if you chose to serve your WeWeb app on the www subdomain, it's very likely that you will want to set up a redirection from the root domain to that subdomain. This is something you would do by creating an alias record on the DNS, which you can do on your domain registrar. However, some domain registrar do not allow you to set up that kind of record. If that's the case with the one you're using, we recommend using Cloudflare as a free workaround. Third takeaway, adding a custom domain to a project requires patience, because you will need to create DNS records that need time to propagate worldwide. If you're not patient and you update a setting and save another one and change another one and don't give it a few minutes or a few hours to propagate, then you will end up not knowing what's working and what's not. Something may work at one point because the change you made is not yet reflected on the DNS, but then 2 hours later, you think you didn't change anything and it stopped working. So please be patient. Give it 20 minutes to 2 hours for things to propagate properly in the DNS. It can even take longer than that. Be patient. But if you need help, do not hesitate to reach out on community.weweb.io and we will do our best to help out.